فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدِ اهْتَدَوْا وَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا هُمْ فِي شِقَاقٍ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، أتممنا ولله الحمد والمنة في الدرس الماضي ما يتعلق بصفة صلاة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. وبعد، we completed in the previous sessions by the praise of Allah that which relates to the prayer.
فكل واحد منا يعتقد أن الصلاة دائما صحيحة والأشياء التي يصنعها في صلاته يعني تامة مستقيمة لا إشكال فيها.
And everybody amongst us always believes that our prayer is the complete and most perfect prayer.
لكن الذي قلنا عليه حال السلف أنهم كانوا كان الواحد منهم يصلي أمام البقية حتى يروا ويروا كيف يصلي. فنحن نجتمع الآن لو كان هناك مجموعات يصلي الواحد منا ونحن نرى يعني هل أخطأ أو أصاب.
But we mentioned that the Salaf, what they used to do is one amongst them would pray in front of everybody else and the others would then tell him of any mistakes that is occurring in his prayer. And like this, this is what we want to do today. That we want to get into small groups of people and each one of you show one rak'ah of the prayer in front of the other brothers. And then those other brothers, they can tell him if there's any deficiencies or any mistakes in the way that he is praying.
نعم. فإذا انتهى الإنسان من صلاته ماذا يصنع؟ إذا فرغ بعد التسليم ماذا يصنع؟
So when a person finishes his prayer after making a taslim, then what should he do?
من يعلم؟ عندما ينتهي الإنسان من صلاة الفريضة ماذا يصنع؟
When a person finishes the obligatory prayer, what should he do after the taslim?
يخرج الجوال.
Does he take out his mobile phone?
ثم ينظر في المكالمات التي وردت أثناء الصلاة أو يرسل بعض الرسائل.
And then he looks at his missed calls or he sends a few messages.
أو يتكلم مع زميله.
Or he starts speaking with a person to his side.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يحافظ على هذه الأوراد أدبار الصلوات المفروضة.
Rather the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to always preserve and persevere upon saying the adhkar, the remembrances after the prayer.
نعم. فالأصل أن تأتي بسنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالأذكار الواردة دبر الصلوات المفروضة.
So therefore, what is upon us that we follow the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم by saying the adhkar, by saying the remembrances which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to say after the prayer.
ذكرنا في الدرس الماضي شروط الصلاة.
We mentioned in the previous lesson the shurut, the conditions of the prayer.
وكذلك ذكرنا في الصفة في صفة الصلاة الأركان.
And also when we were describing the prayer, we mentioned the pillars, the arkan.
الركن الأول القيام. قلنا لابد من القيام في صلاة الفريضة.
And we said that the first pillar from the arkan or the pillars of the prayer is al-qiyam, which is the standing. So a person has to stand when he is praying the faraid prayers, the obligatory prayers.
فإذا عجز عن القيام بالكلية سقط عنه القيام.
But if a person isn't able to stand up completely, then he doesn't need to stand up. Then that obligation, it is removed from him.
الركن الثاني تكبيرة الإحرام أي قول الله أكبر.
The second pillar, it is تكبيرة الإحرام, which is the first takbir that a person makes saying Allahu Akbar to initiate the prayer.
فلا يمكن لأي أحد أن يدخل في الصلاة إلا بتكبيرة الإحرام.
It's not possible for any person to enter into the prayer or to begin his prayer without the first تكبيرة الإحرام.
وقراءة الفاتحة لابد منها في كل ركعة.
And also the recitation of Surah Al-Fatiha is a pillar which must be done in every single unit of prayer.
تقرأ في كل ركعة.
It is recited in every rak'ah. Whether the prayer is a voluntary prayer or it is an obligatory prayer. Whether it is one of the quiet prayers or the loud prayers. And a person is not allowed to leave anything from Surah Al-Fatiha. And then the next pillar, the next rukun is al-ruku', which is the bowing. And then standing up straight after the bowing.
والسجود على الأعضاء السبعة السجدة الأولى والثانية.
And then a person making two prostrations, two sujood on the seven body parts that we mentioned.
والاعتدال من السجود.
And then sitting up, upright after the sujood or between the two sujoods.
والجلسة بين السجدتين.
And a person sitting between the sujoods.
نعم. والطمأنينة لابد أن يطمئن. والطمأنينة تكون في الغالب بأن يأتي بالذكر الواجب في كل ركن من الأركان.
And also from the pillars, the arkan of the prayer is الطمأنينة. And الطمأنينة is performing the prayer in a calm fashion, meaning that in every position of the prayer, you are completely able to say that which needs to be said.
يعني في السجود لو قال سبحان ربي الأعلى مرة واحدة في الغالب أنه حقق الطمأنينة.
As an example, if in the sujood, in the prostration, a person says once سبحان ربي الأعلى, then this is طمأنينة in the sujood.
يعني ضد هذا أنه ينقر الصلاة, يعني لا ترى يعني يبقى ولا ثانية واحدة في الركوع ولا في السجود مثلا.
So the opposite of this is when a person, he's quick in every single position of the prayer. So even for a second, he doesn't rest in the sujood or the rukur. Rather, he's up and down and he's quick in the prayer.
نعم. والترتيب بين الأركان لابد أن يرتب الصلاة كما جاء عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. يعني لا يصح أنه يسجد أولا ثم بعد هذا الأركان.
And then the other pillar of the prayer is الترتيب, meaning that all of these pillars, all of these arkan are done in the correct order. Meaning a person can't make sujood before he makes ruku', as an example.
كذلك التشهد الأخير.
Also from the arkan, from the pillars of the prayer, is the last final tashahud.
والجلوس له.
And sitting for it.
والصلاة على النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام والصلاة الإبراهيمية.
And sending peace and salutations upon the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم by saying the Salat Ibrahimiyya.
والتسليمتان.
And then making the two salams, the two taslim.
نعم. طيب واجبات الصلاة.
Next are the wajibat or the obligations of the prayer.
جميع التكبيرات عدا تكبيرة الإحرام, لأن تكبيرة الإحرام ركن.
All of the takbirat apart from تكبيرة الإحرام, all of the others are from the wajibat, because تكبيرة الإحرام is from the pillars.
يعني يكبر عندما يريد السجود, هذا من الواجبات. يقول الله أكبر.
Meaning when a person wants to go from standing into sujood, then he has to say الله أكبر.
أعطينا. في قرص.
شيخ هذه ال.
في قرص هنا موجود فيه ما أقول, وهذا مكتوب كل ما أقول في الكتاب.
لم يكن موجود في اللابس الشيخ.
كتاب. ماذا قلنا آخر كلمة قلنا؟
قلت آخر كلمة الموضوع التسليم, أنا التسليم ذكرت أن التسليمتين من ال من ال ال pillars أيش اسمه من الأركان.
تمام. يقول آخر كلمة قلتها أنا أن التسليمتان من الأركان, صحيح؟ ليس بصحيح. يقول ليس.
طيب شيخ دعني أراجع ما كتبته. يا رجل شيخ أشوف توريت
شيخ. طيب لا
إيه أشوف التكبيرات. أيوة. غير تكبير الإحرام هي من الواجبات. شفت صحيح هذا شيخ؟
لا يسوي صحيح.
آخر كلام أن التكبيرات كل التكبيرات واجبات.
الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى يقول الأولى بالطالب أنه يستمع إلى الدرس. يعني الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله أعلم مني ومنكم, صحيح؟ نحسبه كذلك الله حسيب. فأنت الآن وقت الدرس استمع. الكتاب موجود فيه هذه الأشياء, أنا ليس عندي علم، أنا فقط أريد أتذاكر معكم. نعم
شيخ. الشيخ ابن عثيمين رحمه الله, he says that in the middle of a lesson, everybody should be listening and paying attention to the lesson, not writing or doing anything else. And Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, I think Allah knows best, is more knowledgeable than me and more knowledgeable than you. And everything that we say, everything is in the book and also in the CD, everything that's being said.
Now, al-wajibat, wajibat al-salah.
So what are the obligations or the wajibat of the prayer?
جميع التكبيرات على تكبيرة الإحرام, لأن تكبيرة الإحرام ركن.
So all of the takbirat, apart from the first takbiratul ihram, which is the rukn, all of the takbirat are from the obligations.
نعم. عندنا من واجبات الصلاة قول قلنا مرة واحدة سبحان ربي العظيم في الركوع.
And also from the wajibat of the prayer we said previously that you have to say at least once سبحان ربي العظيم in the ركوع, at least once.
والزيادة سنة.
And as for saying it more times, then this is recommended.
بما ورد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And we also say that other remembrances which have been narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قول سمع الله لمن حمدا للإمام والمنفرد.
Also a person saying سمع الله لمن حمدا, whether he's the imam or he's praying alone.
قول ربنا ولك الحمد للجميع إمام ومنفرد ومأموم.
And from the obligations is say the saying ربنا ولك الحمد for the imam, for the person praying in congregation behind the imam and the person praying on his own.
قول سبحان ربي الأعلى مرة واحدة في السجود.
Also a person saying سبحان ربي الأعلى at least once as an obligation in the sujood.
والزيادة سنة.
And as for the other remembrances on top of this, and this is sunnah.
بما ورد.
According to that which has been narrated.
قول رب اغفر لي بين السجدتين.
A person saying رب اغفر لي between the two sujood whilst he's sitting.
التشهد الأول.
The first تشهد
والجلوس له
and sitting for it.
نعم. يبقى معنا سنن الصلاة ذكرناها في الصفة.
And as for the sunan, the recommended acts of the prayer, then we have mentioned them when we spoke about the description of the prayer.
مبطلات الصلاة.
Those matters which invalidate and break a person's prayer.
ما هي مبطلات الصلاة؟
What are the invalidators of the prayer?
من الذي يعرف مبطلات الصلاة؟
Who knows?
الذي لا يعرف مبطلات الصلاة قد تكون صلاته باطلة وهو لا يدري.
So the person who doesn't know the invalidators of the prayer, those matters which invalidate a person's prayer, perhaps your prayer is invalidated and you don't know. Perhaps you've done one of those things.
العلماء رحمهم الله ألفوا في مبطلات الصلاة. نعم.
The scholars, they authored books all about the things which invalidate a person's prayer.
في نواقض الوضوء.
And also those matters which invalidate a person's wudu, break a person's wudu.
نواقض الإسلام.
And also those matters which invalidate a person's Islam.
المفطرات أو مفسدات الصيام.
And those matters which break a person's fast.
محظورات الإحرام.
And again those things which invalidate a person's Hajj or his Ihram in Hajj.
ما الفائدة؟
What is the purpose behind all of this? What's the benefit?
هل أرادوا بهذا التأليف إبطال الصلاة والصيام والإسلام والحج والصيام؟
So by writing these books regarding these subjects, did the scholars merely want to invalidate people's prayers and soul and Hajj and so on and so forth?
لا. أرادوا بهذا أن تجتنب هذه الأشياء حتى لا تكون صلاتك باطلة.
No, what they want from you is that you should avoid these things so your prayer doesn't become invalidated.
إذن ألف العلماء رحمه الله تعالى نواقض الإسلام حتى لا تقع في ناقض. إذن ليس الغرض من التأليف تكفير الناس, لا, الغرض حتى لا نقع في هذا ويكون بهذا الصلاة والسلام خروج من الدين.
So the reason why the scholars, for example, spoke about those things which invalidate a person's Islam isn't because they want to call you a kafir and make takfir of you, but to help you stay away from these things and protect your religion.
إذن هذا من النصح للأمة.
So therefore, this is from sincere advice to the Ummah.
إذن الذي لا يعرف مبطلات الصلاة قد تكون صلاة باطلة وهو لا يدري.
So the person who doesn't know those matters which will break or invalidate his prayer, perhaps he has invalidated his prayer and he doesn't know.
والذي لا يعرف نواقض الإسلام قد يكون يخرج بشيء من الإسلام إلى الكفر وكذلك هو لا يدري.
And a person who doesn't know those matters which invalidate his Islam, maybe he'll end up doing something or saying something and he leaves the religion of Islam and he doesn't know.
إذن هذه أمور مهمة لابد أن نتعلمها.
So these matters are very important, we have to learn them.
قبل أن نبدأ بمبطلات الصلاة نريد أن نتكلم عن الحركات في الصلاة. أي حركة في الصلاة لابد أن تندرج تحت أنواع خمسة.
Before we speak about those matters which invalidate and break a person's prayer, we want to speak about the types of movements in the prayer. So any movement that a person makes in the prayer, it can be categorized in one of five categories.
حركة محرمة.
Either the movement is haram, it's forbidden.
حركة مكروهة.
Or it is disliked.
حركة مباحة.
Or the movement is permitted and allowed.
حركة مستحبة.
Or the movement is recommended.
حركة واجبة.
Or the movement is an obligation.
الحركة المحرمة مثل.
The actions or the movements which are forbidden in the prayer are like.
الأكل.
Eating.
والشرب.
Drinking.
والضحك.
Laughing.
والالتفات عن القبلة.
And turning away from the قبلة.
والحركة الكثيرة المتوالية عرفا لغير أتركها. نعم. هذه أمثلة على الحركات المحرمة في الصلاة.
So these are examples of movements in the prayer that are not allowed. They are not permitted.
نعم. الحركة المكروهة.
And as for those movements which are disliked.
هي حركة قليلة وليست بكثيرة لكن لغير حاجة.
It is a person doing small amount of movement, so not a lot, but when there isn't a need for him to make that movement.
الالتفات اليسير في الصلاة مكروه. الالتفات الكثير محرم.
So for example, a person turning slightly away from the Qibla, this is makruh. This is disliked. And a person turning away from the Qibla in totality is haram.
الثالث الحركة المباحة.
As for those movements which are allowed and permitted,
الحركة المباحة التي تكون لحاجة
is a permitted type of movement which is done out of necessity.
مثال
as an example,
يعني وهو يصلي سقط من جيبه شيء من المال مثلا وخاف عليه من السرقة فبأدنى حركة أرجع المال إلى جيبه.
So an example of a movement which is permitted in the prayer is if a person was praying and he went down and let's say some money fell from his pocket. And he's scared that maybe somebody is going to steal that money. So with the least amount of movement, he picks up that money and he places it back in his pocket.
نعم. الحركة المستحبة.
And then the fourth type of movement is the movement which is recommended.
هي الحركة التي يتوقف عليها كمال الصلاة.
And this is the type of movement that a person has to make in order to perfect his prayer.
مثال سد الفرج.
As an example, closing the gaps.
الخامس الحركة الواجبة.
And then the fifth type of movement is the movement which is an obligation.
وهي الحركة التي يتوقف عليها صحة الصلاة. إن لم يتحرك كانت الصلاة باطلة.
And this is the movement a person has to do in order for the prayer to be complete. And if he doesn't make that movement, then his prayer isn't correct, neither is it complete.
مثال وهو يصلي الآن وجد على غترته أو على الجوربين نجاسة ماذا يصنع؟
As an example, if somebody is praying and then he realizes that on his socks or his scarf is a najasa, is an impurity, what does he do?
هنا لابد من حركة واجبة يخلع الغترة أو يخلع الجوربين حتى تكون الصلاة صحيحة.
So here the person has to make a movement. If he wants to keep his prayer complete and intact, then he has to either remove his scarf or remove his socks in order to remove the impurity.
مرة أخرى حركة واجبة.
So one more time, the movements in the prayer is either an obligation,
كإزالة النجاسة,
like a person removing impurities.
حركة مستحبة.
Or a movement which is recommended,
كسد الفرج,
like closing the gaps, moving to close the gaps.
حركة مباحة.
A movement which is permitted and allowed.
قلنا مثاله لو سقط من جيبه شيء من النقود.
Like as an example, something was to fall out of the pocket and then he picks it up and he puts it back down.
حركة مكروهة حركة يسيرة لغير حاجة.
And a disliked movement, and that is those that is that type of movement which is little, it's not a lot, but there's no necessity for a person to make that movement.
الخامس الحركة المحرمة الضحك والأكل والشرب.
And then the fifth type of movement is the movement which is not allowed, it is forbidden, like eating and drinking, laughing and so on and so forth.
مبطلات الصلاة.
So now what are those things which invalidate a person's prayer?
الكلام العمد مع العلم والذكر.
A person speaking intentionally and he knows and he remembers.
يعني تكلم في الصلاة.
As an example, somebody speaks in the prayer.
وهو ذاكر لا ناسي.
And he isn't forgetful. He knows what he's doing.
عالما بتحريم الكلام بالصلاة.
And he also knows that speech in the prayer breaks his prayer and it's not allowed. He knows this.
متعمد.
And he does it on purpose, intentionally.
فالصلاة باطلة.
So his prayer is invalid.
الثاني من مبطلات الصلاة الحركة الكثيرة. نعم.
The second invalidator of the prayer is a person who does a lot of frequent movements.
متتابعة متوالية.
And in succession.
عرفا يعني تراه تظن أنه غير مصلي من كثرة ما يتحرك.
To an extent that if another person was to see that person who is moving during the prayer, he would think that he isn't praying.
بدون حاجة.
And especially when there's no need for him to make those movements.
حركة.
So a movement.
كثيرة.
Which is a lot and frequent.
متتابعة.
And successive.
عرفا يعني تراه تظن أنه غير مصلي.
Such that if it was seen by another person, he would think that this person isn't praying. So many movements.
لغير حاجة.
And there's no need or necessity for that person to make those movements.
يعني يخرج الجوال مثلا من جيبه ثم ينظر سبحان الله يقول من هذا ويفتح الجوال ثم ينظر في الرسائل ولعله يرد عليها ويقول أنا أصلي. تنظر إليه تظن غير مصلي من كثرة ما يتحرك.
So like a person who gets out of his mobile phone, looks through his messages, maybe opens his phone, he might even answer and say, look, I'm praying right now, and then he puts it back down. So the person who is looking at him would not think that this person is praying.
نعم. الضحك.
Also, from the invalidators of the prayer is laughing.
الأكل والشرب.
Eating and drinking.
يعني يضع في هذا الجيب مثلا شيء من الطعام وفي هذا الجيب شيء من الشراب ويأكل ويشرب وهو يصلي.
So a person who is praying and yet he eats and drinks from his right and left pocket.
الانحراف الكثير عن القبلة.
Also from the invalidators of the prayer is a person who deviates away from the Qibla by a larger amount.
انتقاض الطهارة.
And also if a person breaks his purification.
يعني حصل له ناقض من نواقض الوضوء كخروج الريح مثلا.
So anything which invalidates a person's wudu, if it occurs in the prayer, then it invalidates his prayer, like the passing of wind.
لكن هذا لابد يكون عن يقين لا شك.
But this has to be based upon certainty and not a mere doubt.
لكن إذا جاء الشيطان وقال هل أنت متوضئ أم لا؟ فهو متوضئ لأنه عندما كبر كبر على طهارة.
But if Shaytan comes to a person and merely suggests to him or whispers to him to make him unsure of whether he is in a state of wudu or not, then he ignores the Shaytan. Why? Because when the person made takbir, then he was upon tahara, upon purity.
نعم. هذا والله أعلم يعني ما يتعلق بشيء مما يكون في الصلاة. يبقى معنا السجود السهو.
So this is what relates to the prayer. Everything we've covered over the last two or three lessons is what relates to the prayer. The thing which remains now is sujood as-sahu, the prostration which is made out of forgetfulness.
Sujood as-sahu, يعني السجود الذي يكون بسبب السهو للعمد.
So sujood as-sahu is the prostration which is done out of forgetfulness, meaning you have forgotten something and therefore you're making sujood as-sahu. So it's not for those things which you left out on purpose.
نعم. سجود السهو له أسباب
ثلاثة. There are three reasons or three main causes why a person has to make sujood as-sahw.
أن يزيد في الصلاة سهوا.
Either a person forgetfully increases something in the prayer,
أو يترك منها شيء.
Or forgetfully he leaves something from the prayer,
أو يشك.
Or he's in doubt.
إذن أسباب السهو ثلاثة.
So therefore, the causes or the reasons why a person has to make sujood as-sahw are three.
زيادة ونقص وشك.
Either an increase of something in the prayer, or taking something away from the prayer, or a doubt.
نتكلم عن الأول عن الزيادة في الصلاة.
So we're going to talk about the first one. If somebody does something extra in the prayer.
في صلاة الظهر مثلا قام للركعة الخامسة.
As an example, in the Dhuhr prayer, a person stands up for a fifth rak'ah, fifth unit of prayer.
متعمداً فالصلاة باطلة.
If he did this on purpose, then his prayer is invalid.
إذا قام للخامسة ناسياً فالصلاة صحيحة.
But if he stood up for the fifth rak'ah forgetfully, then his prayer is correct.
فماذا يصنع؟
However, what should he do?
مجرد ما يتذكر ويعرف أنه في الخامسة يقطع هذه ويرجع يجلس.
As soon as he realizes that this is his fifth unit of prayer, then he ends that fifth unit and he goes back down to the sitting position.
وعلى سجود السهو.
And then he makes سجود السهو.
الثاني النقص.
And as for a person who has taken something away from the prayer, is deficient in the prayer.
نعم. النقص عندنا إذا كان النقص والترك للأركان فالصلاة باطلة لا شك في بطلانها حتى يأتي بالركن الذي ترك.
So if the person who missed out this action in the prayer, if the action which he missed out from was from the arkan, from the pillars which we have mentioned, then his prayer is not accepted.
يعني مثلا ترك قراءة الفاتحة في الركعة الأولى.
As an example, in the first rak'ah he prayed, a person he didn't say Surah Al-Fatiha. He forgot to recite Surah Al-Fatiha.
وتيقن في الركعة الثانية أنه لم يقرأ الفاتحة في الأولى. يقين 100%.
But when it came to the second rak'ah, then he remembered with absolute certainty, without any doubt, that he hasn't recited Surah Al-Fatiha in the first unit.
يرجع إلى هذا الموضع الذي ترك فيه الركن يعني الركعة الأولى عند قراءة الفاتحة وقرأ الفاتحة.
So he now has to assume the position in which he did not, in which he missed out that action. So he has to now assume that he has gone back to the first ركعة in order to recite سورة الفاتحة.
ومن هنا يبدأ يستمر في الصلاة يعني يكمل الأولى ثم الثانية ثم الثالثة ثم الرابعة. كل شيء فعله بعد ترك الركن لاغي انتهى.
And then from this position, he commences the prayer. So if he went back to the first rak'ah to recite Surah Al-Fatiha, then the next rak'ah is going to be second and third. So anything which he has done after leaving of the pillar or missing out the pillar, then this is not accepted.
إذن لو ترك ركن من الأركان لا تصح الصلاة. لا بد الاتيان بهذا الركن وبما بعد الركن.
So if a person missed out a ركن, a pillar from the pillars of the prayer, then anything after is not accepted. So he has to go back, repeat the rukun from that position, and then build on from there.
أما ترك واجب من الواجبات.
And as for a person who omits an obligation from the wajibat of the prayer, the obligations of the prayer,
إذا انتقل عن مكان هذا الواجب لا يرجع إليه وصلاته صحيحة ويسجد للسهو.
If a person he missed out an obligation of the prayer, but he's moved on now. He's moved on to another position. He doesn't need to come back to this position. His prayer is correct as long as he makes sujood as-sahw.
يعني نسي التشهد الأول وقام.
As an example, in the second unit, in the second rak'ah, a person forgot the tashahud and he stood up for the third rak'ah.
فماذا أصنع؟
What should he do?
التشهد الأول واجب من واجبات الصلاة.
Knowing that the first تشهد, it is an obligation from the obligations of the prayer.
هل انتقل من مكان هذا الواجب؟ نعم.
Has he moved on to another, to the next position? Yes, he has.
فلا يرجع ويجلس. يتم الثالثة ثم الرابعة ويسجد للسهو.
So as long as he has moved on to another position now, meaning he's now got up and he's gone on to his third rak'ah, then he doesn't need to go back to the second rak'ah. Rather, he completes his third rak'ah and he completes his fourth rak'ah and then he does sujood as-sahw.
القسمة الثالث.
And then the third type,
الشك,
is a person who does sujood السهو due to a doubt.
عندنا الشك إما أن يكون بعد الانتهاء والفراغ من العبادة أو داخل العبادة.
So this doubt which occurs, either it occurs after a person has completed the prayer and finished from the prayer, or it occurs during the prayer itself.
لا, في كل العبادات, في الصلاة وفي الطهارة وفي الوضوء وفي الاغتسال, في كل العبادات ينقسم الشك إلى قسمين, داخل العبادة وبعد الفراغ والانتهاء من العبادة, حتى في الطواف وفي السعي.
In fact, in every type of worship, every type of ibadah, the same classification can apply. Either the doubt is in the middle of that which you are doing, whether it's tawaf, whether it's sa'i, whether it's ghusl or wudu or the prayer or tahara, or the doubt occurs after you have completed the act of worship, regardless of what the act of worship is.
نعم. إذن الشك عندنا ينقسم إلى قسمين.
So once more, doubt can be classified into two categories.
داخل العبادة وبعد الفراغ والانتهاء من العبادة.
Either during and in the middle of the act of worship, or after a person has completed the act of worship.
الشك الذي يكون بعد الفراغ والانتهاء من العبادة هذا لا يلتفت إليه إطلاقا.
If doubt occurs in your mind after you have finished the act of worship, then you don't turn to it at all. You give it no consideration.
يعني طاف الآن بالبيت سبع أشواط.
As an example, somebody, he makes tawaf around the Kaaba 7 times.
وصلى سنة الطواف.
And then he has prayed the 2 sunnah behind Maqam Ibrahim.
وعندما أراد الذهاب إلى السعي شك هل طاف 6 أشواط أو 7 أشواط.
And then when this person now wants to move on to make sa'i between Safa and Marwa, he has a doubt. Have I done 6 circulations around the Kaaba or 7?
انتهى الطواف.
Has the tawaf finished? Has he finished from the tawaf?
نعم لا يمكن يرجع.
Yes, he has, so he does not return.
لو رجع فهو آثم.
If he returns, then he is sinning.
توضأ.
If a person, as an example, he makes wudu.
ثم دخل المسجد.
And then he enters into the masjid.
وشك هل مسح رأسه أم لا.
And then a doubt comes to him in his mind. Did I wipe over my head or did I not?
لو رجع فهو آثم. لو رجع وتوضأ مرة أخرى فهو آثم.
If the person returns on the basis of this doubt, and then he makes wudu once again, then he is sinning.
لأن الوضوء انتهى. لا يرجع.
Why? Because the wudu has finished. He doesn't need to return.
إلا إذا تيقن 100% أنه ما غسل الرأس.
Unless it was an absolute certainty without any doubt, 100%, that he forgot to wipe over his head.
كبر تكبيرة الإحرام.
A person, he says تكبيرة الإحرام to initiate the prayer.
ثم بعد التكبيرة بدأ يوسوس يشك هل هو متوضئ أم لا.
And then,
هل انتقض وضوءه أم لا.
After he has commenced the prayer, a doubt comes to him. And the doubt is, has he made wudu or has he not made wudu? Did he break his wudu or did he not break his wudu?
لا يمكن له أن يخرج من الصلاة لأنه عندما كبر كبر على يقين أنه متوضئ. يحرم عليه الخروج من الصلاة. لو خرج فهو آثم.
It's not allowed for him to break his prayer and leave his prayer now to make wudu. Why? Because when he initially did takbiratul ihram, he only did takbiratul ihram knowing 100% that he is upon wudu. So if he breaks his prayer in order to go make wudu once again on the basis of this doubt, then he is sinning.
هذا الأخ الآن صلى معنا العصر.
This brother, for example, he prayed Asr with us.
وقال الآن أنا أشك 99% أنني لم أقرأ الفاتحة في الركعة الرابعة.
And the brother, he says that I have a 90% doubt that I did not recite Surat al-Fatiha in one of the units of the prayer.
هل أرجع وأعيد الصلاة؟
Should he go and repeat his prayer once more?
انتهت الصلاة.
As long as the prayer has finished,
نعم إذا لم يكن ترجع,
then he should not be returning and repeating the prayer.
لو أعدت الصلاة فأنت آثم.
And if he repeats the prayer, then he is sinful.
إذن عندنا قاعدة لا يمكن التفت للشكوك بعد أن تنتهي العبادة.
So therefore, the principle that we have is, it isn't allowed for a person to repeat the act of worship on the basis of a doubt as long as the act of worship has finished.
نعم. والشريعة جاءت لقطع الوسواس.
And the Sharia, this Islamic legislation, it only came to stop these whisperings.
نعم. والوساوس من أين تأتي؟
And this whispering, this doubt, where does it come from?
من الشيطان.
From a shaitan.
فلو كنت تسير ولا وساوس فأنت سائر وراء إبليس.
So if you keep following these whisperings and this doubt, then you're following the whisperings of a shaitan.
طيب أقول قد تكون صلاتي باطلة.
A person might say, okay, perhaps there's a possibility that my prayer is invalid.
نقول هذا الكلام من أين أتى لك؟
We say that this speech which you're saying, where did it come from?
من الشريعة.
Did it come from the Sharia?
لا, الشريعة لا تأمرك بهذا.
No, because the Sharia does not order with this.
هذا من الشيطان.
Rather, this speech has come from a shaitan.
وأكثر ما يكون من الشكوك في الطهارة.
And most of the doubts and confusion which occurs are doubts regarding purification.
بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه يظن أن به سلس بول.
Some people, may Allah guide and guide them, they think that they suffer from continuous urine.
نعم, ويظن أنه بعد أن يتبول أنه يخرج منه نقطة بول, نقطة من البول مثلا.
And that person, he'll think that every time he has finished urinating and left, that more droplets or a droplet of urine has been discharged.
فماذا يصنع؟
So what should he do?
يقفز في دورة المياه.
He jumps whilst he's urinating.
أو يخطو خطوات كثيرة يلف حول المسجد.
Or that person goes for a walk around the masjid a few times.
أو تضيع عليه الصلاة وهو لا يخرج إلى المسجد أصلا ما يستطيع.
Or he ends up missing the prayer because he thinks in his mind that I can't possibly pray.
أو يصنع أشياء. نقول طالما أتيت بالطهارة التي أمرك الله سبحانه وتعالى بها, حتى لو خرج شيء يسير كما يقول هذا نقطة, هذا النقطة لا تضر على ما يقول شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى, ولا تلتفت إلى هذه الوساوس. وفي الغالب أن هذا الذي يخرج أثر غسل الذكر بالماء.
So what should this person do? We say that as long as you have purified yourself according to the way in which the Sharia has taught us, then even if there was a discharge of a droplet, then it will not affect you, like Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said. So therefore, a person does not turn to it at all, gives it no thought at all. In fact, in most cases, what the person thinks is a droplet of urine will actually be a droplet of water from his istinja.
نعم. إذن كل شك بعد الانتهاء من العبادة لا نلتفت إليه.
So therefore, the principle is that any doubt which occurs to a person after the completion of the act of worship, then he does not turn to it and pays it no consideration.
القسم الثاني.
But the second type of doubt,
الشك إذا كان داخل العبادة,
is a doubt which occurs in the middle of an act of worship or during the act of worship.
يعني شك الآن في صلاة الظهر, هل صلى ثلاث ركعات أم أربع ركعات؟
Meaning a person is praying dhuhr and then he has a doubt, is this my third raka'ah or is this my fourth raka'ah?
فماذا يصنع؟
What should he do?
نسأل هذا.
We ask him,
هل هذا الأمر يحدث معك باستمرار أو نادر؟
This doubt which has occurred in your mind, is it something which is always happening to you, continuously you keep having these types of doubts, or is it something which is a one-off, it's very rare?
لا, يقول هذا دائم يحدث معي.
And the person says, no, inside the prayer I always have this doubt.
ودائما أشك هل سجدت سجدة أو سجدتين.
And I always have a doubt, did I make one sujood or two sujood?
نقول أنت موسوس لا تلتفت إلى هذا وتجعلها دائما سجدتين وتجعلها دائما أربع ركعات.
So this type of person who always gets the doubt and the whisperings inside the prayer, we say to him that you are somebody who has been afflicted with the whisperings of a shaitan. So whenever the whisper or the doubt comes to you, just assume that you have done two sujood and assume that you have prayed for raka'at.
نعم. يعني إذا يشك دائما في صلاته هل يسجد سجدة أو سجدتين؟ نقول أنت كثير الوساوس تجعلها دائما سجدتين. ولا شيء عليك ولا سجود سهو.
So this person who always has doubts in the prayer, we say to him that you have been afflicted by the wasawis, the whisperings of a shaitan. So therefore, just assume that it's your second sujood or it's your fourth rak'ah of the prayer and there's nothing upon you and you don't have to make sujood the sahu.
نعم, دائما يشك هل صلى ثلاث ركعات أو أربع ركعات.
he's always in a doubt. Is this my third rak'ah or is this my fourth rak'ah?
نقول أنت موسوس تجعلها دائما أربع ركعات ولا شيء عليك.
We say that you are someone who has been afflicted by the waswas and therefore assume it is your fourth rak'ah.
نعم. القسم الثاني.
But then the other type of person.
قليل الشكوك نادرا ما يشك هل صلى ثلاث ركعات أو أربع ركعات.
Is somebody who doesn't usually have doubts. It's something which is very rare that he has a doubt regarding has he prayed a third rak'at or is this his fourth rak'at?
نقول ما الذي يترجح لديك غلبة الظن هل هي ثلاث ركعات أم أربع ركعات؟
So we ask him that in your mind what has the highest probability? The highest probability in your mind is have you prayed four, have you prayed three?
إذا قال يترجح لدي أنها ثلاث ركعات نقول اجعلها ثلاث ركعات وصلاة الرابعة ثم تسجد للسهو.
So if the person says no, I think with the highest probability that I've prayed three rak'at, we say, okay, this is your third rak'at, pray a fourth rak'at, and then make sujood al-sahw.
وَإِذَا قَلَ يَتَرَجَّحْ لَدَيْهَا أَنَّهَا أَرْبَعَ رَكَعَاتٍ نَقُلْ اجْعَلْهَا أَرْبَعَ رَكَعَاتٍ وَاسْجُدْ لِلسَّهْوِ.
And if a person says that, no, I think with the highest probability that this is my fourth rak'at, then we say, okay, complete your prayer and make sujood al-sahw.
وَإِذَا قَلْ لَمْ يَتَرَجَّحْ لَدَيْهَا شَيْءٍ.
But if the person says that I don't know, nothing is more probable than the other one.
نقول الآن تبني هنا على الأقل ثلاث ركعات.
And here we say to him that start on from the least amount, i.e. three ركعات.
مرة أخرى.
So one more time.
الشك ينقسم إلى قسمين.
There are two types of doubt.
بعد الفراغ والانتهاء من العبادة لا التفت إليه إطلاقا.
Either after completing the act of worship, you don't pay it any consideration.
داخل العبادة.
Or the second type of doubt is that which occurs in the middle of the act of worship, during the act of worship.
ينقسم إلى قسمين.
And this also is divided into two categories.
كثير الشكوك لا التفت إليه.
Somebody who often has doubts and whisperings, again, he does not pay attention to it.
قليل الشكوك يبني على ما ترجح لديه.
And as for the second type of person who very rarely has these doubts, then first he looks, if there is a higher probability of one of the two, then he goes towards that.
لم يترجح لديه شيء يبني على الأقل.
But if he is absolutely confused and there's nothing which is more likely, then he always builds on that which is the lowest number.
نعم والله أعلم صلى الله عليه وسلم محمد وعلى صحبه وسلم.